What is up, my friends, and welcome back to your Dailies of Fortnite here at the Happy Power channel. Today we have for you guys today's Dailies Refresh, and most importantly, the next upcoming update information. Now before we get to all that amazing topics, we do have for you guys something first up. So I'd like to give a massive shout out to one of my good friends. Now I met this person quite a long time ago, but he's been making me art every single season for absolutely free just because he appreciates the channel. And for that, I cannot tell you guys how much I appreciate him and how much I want to give back to him. So he goes by the name of iProjectRaw, and he's absolutely just an incredible artist. He's been making me art for the past couple of seasons, and you know, just complete random, he would make me all kinds of stuff like this in the background video. So if you guys could do me the absolute amazing favor of just checking him out down below, and if you guys really like his work, you know, pay him to actually do some work, because he's got great prices, very fast work, and his artwork is just absolutely top notch. So if you want to make your channel look absolutely amazing, or your Twitter, Instagram, or any other social media, I highly suggest iProjectRaw, and the first link in the description will definitely be him, so definitely check him out down below, and drop a follow and tell him happy sent you guys. But getting back in today's video, we actually have for you guys our first upcoming topic. So located across the Fortnite Season 9 map, there's actually these images. Now we can definitely tell it appears to be teasing Polar Peak being completely removed from Fortnite Season 9. So the images on the left are recreations of the images on the right that are located across the Fortnite map. Now we can definitely tell Polar Peak and all its accessories are absolutely just completely gone. So does that mean that Polar Peak will be removed during the season? I definitely think so. We've seen this quite a few times, and a lot of the time, there's usually something missing from the images, and it's usually a tease towards what's going to be coming. Quite frankly, I definitely think, considering the fact that it's cracked, and they're actually teasing that, you know, it's probably going to be gone, I can 100% say that yes, it's probably going to be gone relatively soon. The iceberg is cracking, the meteor got hit by it, all kinds of crazy stuff are happening, and yeah, it's just a dead area now, you know, it's a dead point of interest, it's from an old season, there's just no point of having it in the game still. But let me know in the comment section down below what you guys think about these images, and have you guys seen these across the Fortnite map? Moving into our next topic, I know a lot of people have actually been covering this lately, but I completely missed out on this, so I want to cover this for today's video. So Ninja actually found out an extreme exploit when it comes to the Shadow Bomb. For some reason, you guys can keep it on if you guys actually go inside of a mountain, or pretty much just don't touch the ground essentially. If you guys just keep bouncing around, you can actually keep the Shadow Bomb on for absolutely forever. There's no time limit. So roll the clip.
Yeah, just climb all the way up. We could just stay in shadow form on the right under this middle. We should stay in shadow form. You know? If you want.
New baller.
Yeah. I'm going north now.
Yeah, we can.
Yeah, hard to say. I just got shot.
So yes guys, that absolutely just needs to be patched. That's a massive exploit, and that will lead to a lot of bad things. So definitely curious to what you guys think about this down below if you guys have not seen it just yet. Now speaking of bad things in the game of Fortnite, we can definitely tell that this should be actually patched. So what you guys just witnessed is essentially from the competitive side. Basically, ever since competitive, a lot of people want the actual, like, what can I call these? Like these like sky drones slash sky platforms. People want those completely disabled during the endgame or after a certain amount of circles. Okay, so that's fine and all, but what if you're trapped on top of there? Or what if you're on top of there and it still looks like it's still on? I'm gonna have for you guys replaying it in the background video. It still looks like it's on, it still makes the sound effects. The visual effects are still there as if the wind is still on. So quite frankly, there needs to be some sort of brand new warning, and there also needs to be a way to get down, like possibly just an only way to get down, but not back up. You know, there should be a way to only get down and not back up like I just said, and that's about it. It would completely solve all the issues that people are having with the fall damage and thinking that it's actually on because the visual effects look like the wind is still moving there, and it looks like it would still carry you down. So definitely a bad error by Epic Games, and hopefully they actually fix this. And hey, did this happen to you guys? Because actually it happened to me quite a few times, and I just seen this on Reddit, and it's absolutely important that we actually get this patched. Moving into our next topic, a brand new feedback question that caters to bad players. Recently, do you feel the game is much easier? 1, the same, or much harder? And you guys can actually go from 1 to 5, 1 being much easier, 5 being much harder. Now this question is just, you know, it just kind of confirms the fact that Epic Games removed the pump to make the game easier for, you know, the 90% of the players that are not good at the game, basically, or the average players, basically. Statistically, according to Epic Games, 90% of the players cannot kill someone with full health and shields, which means there's only 10% of the players that are above average, or of course, the competitive players. And essentially, that was why the pump shotgun was removed and why we are seeing this message. Ever since the removal of the pump shotgun, or, you know, just basically the nerf of a lot of great weapons and the introducing of, you know, the assault shotgun and stuff like that, that takes quite a few bullets to kill somebody, the game does feel easier. I must admit that, and the game is in fact easier, but that does not mean it's actually better for the average player. You know, competitive-wise, yes, it's horrible for them, and even for the average players, in my personal opinion, it's just not good. I just don't like the way it is. Sometimes the game feels too easy to the point where I'm just an average player. I don't see myself as a pro player at all whatsoever, but I in fact am above average, and especially as of lately, I've been getting a lot better since this last update where the pump shotgun has been removed. And that's mostly because I'm not dying from a one-shot kill, which yes, the game is in fact easier, so I would definitely vote 1 for much easier. So let me know in the comment section down below, do you guys feel as if the game is easier lately ever since the pump shotgun has been removed, and have you guys been doing better each and every single game? And now for our final topic, performance and competitive communication update. So over the past weekend, there's been a lot of issues, such as disconnecting duos update, the upcoming balance adjustments, hold the swap feature coming in 9.10, performance issues, and so much more. Now, I don't really feel the need to read through all of this stuff, so I will link the official link in the description down below as the second link. Of course, the first link is going to be iProject Raw. Like I said, guys, definitely check them out. Amazing artists. But the second link will feature an entire post from Epic Games. It's basically discussing the weekend updates, the 9.10 update, what's going to be coming, what's going to be fixed, and all that great, amazing stuff. It's just too much to read from the video, as I don't want to make this too long. So, as far as today's video goes, that's all I have for you guys for this particular video. As always, if you are new around here, I would highly appreciate if you guys drop a like on today's video and subscribe with those notifications on. Likes and watch time tremendously help the video out tremendously and help it get out to more people. So, if you guys could, please watch the video all the way through if you have time, and drop a like if you guys actually can. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. Hope to see you guys in the next one, and as always, stay happy. Can't wait to see me now, 'cause lately you've been feeling down.